Jay Haynes with the Film Sensei YouTube channel. Today in this video, I'll be teaching an absolute beginner's lesson on the basics of how to use the free version of CapCut. Before we get started, please do me a favor and hit that like button. And if you haven't already, feel free to subscribe to the channel for more content like this. Now, on with the lesson. Today, I'll be working in the desktop version of CapCut, but the principles are basically the same for both the iOS and Android versions. Once you've downloaded and installed the free version of CapCut, this window will pop up. Start by selecting Create New Project, then you'll see this workspace layout. Important panels to know include the Media panel, where you'll keep important assets for your project, such as videos, images, and audio clips. The Player panel, where you'll be able to preview your final video as well as image and video assets. The Editor timeline, where you'll build your final video project. And the Details panel, where you can square away any of the details that you need to. Right now, the Details panel is reflecting the details of the project itself. By clicking on Modify, you can give your project a name, save it wherever you like, and adjust other things such as the aspect ratio, the frame rate, and the color space. Then, when you're ready, click Save. Media assets include video, audio, and images. To import media assets, simply drag and drop them directly into the Media panel. To preview a specific video clip or image, simply click on it to display it in the Player panel. What's really cool is you can also drag and drop a clip directly into the Editor timeline, and it will automatically be added to the Media panel for you. To place a clip on the Editor timeline, simply drag and drop it there. Notice that when you do, the Details panel changes to reflect the details of the clip rather than the project. You can zoom the Editor timeline in and out using this slider. Also, you can zoom to fit everything that you have on the timeline with this button. To add another clip, simply drag and drop it next to the first one, and you can add as many as you like. Also know that you can drag a clip to a layer track above the original, and you can have as many layer tracks as you want. You can adjust the height of any track by simply clicking and dragging. These layer stacks are displayed in the video panel top down. In other words, it's like the camera is above the stack and the clip on top will be shown first. Note that in the Android and iOS versions of CapCut, this is reversed. The clip shown first is on the bottom of the layer stack, so it's like the camera is underneath looking up. That's honestly the major difference between the desktop version and the mobile versions of CapCut. Your basic editing tools can be found here. The selection tool is active by default, and the keyboard shortcut for that is A. You'll use this tool to grab and move clips around, as well as trim the ends. The blade tool is here, and the keyboard shortcut for that is B. You can use this tool to slice a clip into two or more clips. Here's a little trick. Regardless of what tool you've selected, you can trim a clip by placing the playhead where you want to trim and then hit either the Q key to trim everything in front of the playhead or the W key to trim everything behind the playhead. If you'd rather click instead, these are the tools that actually do that. Remember that you can always undo anything by using the shortcut Ctrl-Z, and here's the tool for that. Deleting a clip is as simple as hitting the Delete key, or you can use the Delete tool here. Other tools include the Mirror tool, the Rotate tool, and the Crop tool. That last tool brings up a special window to help you do that. Also, you'll find the Rotate feature in here as well. The Details panel contains a lot of these properties also. In addition, here's where you can adjust the opacity, remove background, and add masks. Under the Audio tab, you can make basic changes to the audio for your clip, and you can adjust the speed of a clip under the Speed tab. Under the Animation tab, you'll find various animations to bring a video in, take it out, or both. And under the Adjustment tab, you can do some color grading. Most of the properties of a clip can be animated through keyframing. However, keyframing, masking, color grading, and other things you can do here are really outside the scope of an absolute beginner's tutorial, so I'll cover those in future tutorials. Don't forget to be subscribed and stay tuned. To add music to your presentation, select the Audio tab here. CapCut provides a bunch of music to choose from. Feel free to search for what you're looking for, and then drag and drop that song into the editor timeline. You can fade the audio in and out here in the Details panel. There's also a little handle on the clip itself that you can grab and drag as well. To access the transitions that can happen between clips, select the Transitions tab. Here you'll find a huge selection to choose from. And when you've found one, simply drag and drop it between two adjacent clips. By selecting the transition, you can then make adjustments in the Details panel. To add text, start by selecting the Text tab. Then click on any text to preview it in the project. If you like it, hit the plus icon to add it to a track, or you can also drag and drop it directly into the editor timeline. Selecting the text layer will cause all of the details to populate in the Details panel. From here, you can make all the adjustments you want. When you're ready to export your project, click on the Export button here. This export pop-up window will appear. Give the video a name, select where you want to save it, and set the other features, which include resolution, bitrate, codec, format, and frame rate. Then when you're ready, click on Export. That's it! I'm Jay Haynes with the Film Sensei YouTube channel, and this has been an absolute beginner's lesson on the basics of how to use the free version of CapCut. Like I said before, if you enjoyed this video, please do me a favor and like it. And if you haven't already, feel free to subscribe to the channel so you won't miss any future CapCut tutorials. Thanks for watching.